Good evening and welcome to this, our Monday, October 14, 2019 edition of News Update. I'm Ashley Scotland. First, the top stories we're tracking this evening. Businessman shot dead outside Kitty Gold dealership as Ghana records 12 murders in 7 days. Pro-democracy activist allegedly assaulted, arrested for protesting unconstitutional president. Partly decomposed body of another piracy victim found. Mother, stepfather arrested as autopsy found 4-year-old boy was sodomized. And in sport, Phil Simmons returns as West Indies head coach as Guyanese Harper and Dowling handed selector roles. These and more coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our 3 locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
Did you know almost 1/3 of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
You know, since me find out about Tire Future Shop, me house look nicer than you one. Hey, hey, credit rate. How you can afford to buy all them things?
I'm going to tell you.
Now me not get catch again. Our secret.
No, come on. I'm magic. You're too fast. Mind the business.
Excuse me, uncle. Tell me something. How credit can afford to buy so much thing from I only now walk no way?
It's because now we introduce our new discount card.
Apply now for your discount card at Tayo Future Shop. Every time you shop using your discount card, your percentage increases. Start from 5% off. Your next purchase, 7% off. Then 10% off, etc. Until you start getting wholesale and factory price. Check in store for more details. Conditions apply.
Help me get me Tayo discount card.
Wait, man. What you gotta do next, man? Buy the whole entire store?
Welcome back now for the news in detail. A businessman is now dead after a gunman opened fire on him in a vehicle in what many believe is an execution. The said businessman was days ago granted 1,200 acres of mining lands together with an APNU AFC official.
Dion Stoll, a gold miner who hailed from Charity, Essequibo Coast, was today killed after two armed bandits attacked him in front of Eldorado Trading in the Silver Street, Newtown. a heavily tinted white Toyota 212 motor car was trailing the businessman and only came to a halt when the businessman's vehicle stopped in front of the establishment. Two armed men, with their face hidden, pounced on the unsuspecting businessman who was in the car with his driver, who also acts as his security. The security managed to haul one of the gunmen out of the car after he entered, but at the same time, the other bandit was riddling shots in the businessman. The men left the scene empty-handed as the security opened fire on them. The businessman later died at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation, while the security and another were injured. Stoll's death leaves many questions, whether it was a robbery or an execution. Only a few days ago, Stoll, along with Dalglish Joseph, was granted a large portion of mining lands.
The partially decomposed, bound body of 20-year-old Lamar Petrie was discovered on the Abara Region 5 Mahaika Berbice foreshore yesterday, Newsroom is reporting. The website said his remains were positively identified by his mother, Onika Simon. The body bore marks of violence, while the hands and feet were tied in a similar manner as that of 36-year-old Kawal Kisun, known as Ajay, of Letakeni village. Kisun's body was also found at the Diabari foreshore on Friday last. They are among four fishermen from the East Berbice quarantine area who were reported missing on Friday after their boat Sara 1 was found abandoned at the Cromarty quarantine Berbice foreshore. The young fishermen left for sea on October 5 and were reportedly attacked and tortured by pirates. Still missing are boat captain 20-year-old Vishnu Siram, called Kevin of Miss Phoebe Portmorant, and Marvin Tamisar, called Buddy. People's Progressive Party presidential candidate Irfan Ali and the party's executive secretary Zulfikar Mustafa yesterday met with the family and relatives of the four men. On Saturday evening, the PP released a press statement calling for no efforts to be spared in locating the other missing men. Earlier last week, two brothers were also chopped and shot to death on Shell Beach, reportedly by pirates. As the People's Progressive Party starts rolling out its policies and plans for Guyanese, a special emphasis will be placed towards improved access, quality and affordability within the education sector. Details from Sandy Ramadar.
Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo said that the party has a strategic plan in place to cater to the needs of the education sector. Jagdeo said the education sector will be geared towards improved access, quality and affordability. The party pledged to bring back the $10,000 school grant and create conditions for youths at the tertiary level.
So our approach is to ensure that access at every level, universal access at every level, from nursery to university. The second objective is to improve quality at every level. The third objective has to do with preparing people for the labor market. So at the tertiary level and at the Tech Voc level, to reorient the programs there so Guyanese can be prepared for the job market.
The party intends to offer 20,000 online scholarships in addition to those done at the University of Guyana. Coupled with this, the party plans to offer free university education within its 5-year term in office. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
The Ghana Agricultural Workers Union has thrown its support behind the People's Progressive Party and its intention to restore the closed sugar estates once it is elected to office again. Details from Sandy Ramutar.
President of the union, Komal Chand, is confident that the closed sugar estates will be reopened once the previous administration returns to power in the March 2020 elections. 10,000 sugar workers were displaced when the three sugar estates were shut on the behest of the now illegal government. The Rose Hall, Skeldon and East Demerara estates were closed in 2017 as the estates were not feasible to maintain. Chan said it is possible for the estates to be reopened, but the necessary capital will have to be injected into the Ghana Sugar Corporation.
Sugar workers are very pleased to hear that statement from the leader of the opposition. Our union is also pleased because it will give workers the opportunity to work, to be employed again. And hopefully that it will address the plight that most of them will be able to take up back work. And what is of concern is that the skilled workers for the factories to operate back, you will require back the skilled workers. So we are hoping that those possibilities will be met.
PPP presidential candidate Irfan Ali has said that the estates will be reopened and the displaced sugar workers will be compensated. The party plans to restore the estates by cutting out the waste in the existing budget. Sandy Ramotar for MTV's News Update.
Supporters of the People's Progressive Party are unceasing in their quest to expose and condemn David Granger, who is deemed to be unconstitutionally hanging on to power. They protested a graduation ceremony where Granger attended, and again there was a heavy deployment of police to protect him.
The opposition People's Progressive Party, among others, has been vigilantly calling for elections to be held following the passage of a motion of no confidence. Recently, Head of State David Granger proclaimed March 2, 2020 as the date for elections as local and international pressure mounted. But despite a date has been named, many Guyanese intend to make Mr. Granger's remaining few months uncomfortable, staging protests at almost every public forum he attends. Yesterday, supporters of the Association for Democracy and Human Rights clashed with police at Cornelia Ida, West Coast Demerara, where Mr. Granger was attending a graduation ceremony for a private school. The protesters came out in their numbers, calling for Mr. Granger to step down, while others were very animated and frustrated over the closure of sugar estates. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Meanwhile, the police denied that anyone was arrested. According to Divisional Commander Lord, two persons were detained at the location but were never taken to the police station. He noted the duo remained with the police until they were calm and then released. Still ahead, mother stepfather arrested as autopsy found 4-year-old boy was sodomized. Amerindian leaders decry deplorable state of their communities on the coalition. And in sport, Phil Simmons returns as West Indies head coach as Guyanese Harper and Dowling handed selector roles. These and more when we return. Stay with us.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at 5 and 10, glistening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store, but the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will.
Using Softex toilet tissue, available in leading supermarkets countrywide. Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, 6-pack, and 1 dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Looking for that outstanding appearance? Check us out at Universal Beauty Salon and Fashion for the best hairstyles, facial, waxing, nail designs, and more. While you're there, be sure to check out our boutique for fashionable men, ladies, and children clothing and footwear in various sizes and colors. We also have in store a variety of costume jewelries. Also, for all types of alcoholic and non-alcoholic beverages in wholesale and retail quantities, our prices are the best around. We are located at 22 Hink Street, Georgetown. Telephone number 223-4117.
It happens. Your septic tank is full. All the waste from your toilet goes into your septic tank through the sewage line. When your tank is full, the two most common indicators are an overflowing tank and an overflowing toilet. It is recommended that Sevon's Waste Management empty your septic tank every 2 to 3 years to avoid any embarrassment. And before you can say, shh, it's gone. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's News Update. Amerindian leaders from Regions 1 and 9 are decrying the neglect of Amerindians and the little progress that has been made for them during the last 4 years. Details from Sandy Ramotar.
Officials from Regions 1 and 9 are not pleased with the manner in which the indigenous peoples are being treated. The regional officials accuse the now illegal government of undermining the role of the regional democratic councils. According to them, the regions have not been able to complete its full scope of work for the year. The officials claim that access to the resources to carry out the region's work plan was being stymied. Less than 50% of the work plan has been completed for Regions 1 and 9.
Taxpayers' dollars approved by Parliament comes to the Regional Democratic Council. It doesn't go to the REO or specifically to an individual, but it comes to the RDC. And the RDC, based on its proposal, have the final saying as to how the money is spent, but they are doing it the other way around. And that's why you'll see in the audit report of this year, of last year, 2018, when it comes out properly, that there will be a lot of queries that is recipe for corruption.
Over the past 3 months, we had some issues with the tender board in Region 9, where the REO Carl Parker, who's heading that tender board, would have awarded about approximately 85% of those contracts, 85% of those contracts using selective tendering. So he would have basically selected almost all PNC people, and give them all these contracts without following the right tender procedure.
The regional officials complained about the constant drug shortages, unemployment, and corrupt activities in the region. Another worrying issue is the excessive spending of taxpayers' dollars used to fund political campaigns and for travel and security purposes.
For the last 4 years, since the APNU, APNU, AFC would have taken the seat of government, the region's economy would have become stagnated. The lack of employment, the lack of economic activities, the lack of investment into communities that we would have seen before May of 2015 would have stopped.
Someone said, one of my colleagues mentioned that 4 years now they have not went into the area, only now because it's elections time. That is indeed true, right? They have not been visiting. So now when they're going into the communities, they're being rejected on most villages. They're being rejected when going in. Some of them go in and bully their way. When we were in office, we would normally write the two shows seeking permission to enter those villages. Today, that's not happening. The minister would just start up and say, I need a meeting. Please gather all your people and we're gonna have a meeting.
Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
A 27-year-old man is now battling for his life at the Georgetown Public Hospital after he was shot while attempting to solicit a taxi with two of his friends yesterday morning, Guyana Times is reporting. The newspaper said Alan Kahumpas of Bestville, West Coast, Demerara, was seen consuming alcohol on Saturday evening with his friends at a popular bar located at Crane Village. Based on information gathered, about 2:30, the trio left the location and were walking along the Crane Old Road, area when they came under fire from one of the occupants of a blue motor car that was driving past them. One of the bullets reportedly hit Humpus to the left side of his abdomen, causing him to fall to the roadway as the car sped away. The injured man was picked and rushed to the West Demerara Regional Hospital, where he was immediately admitted. Upon initial examination, it was confirmed that the bullet was lodged in his abdomen. He was later transferred to the Georgetown Public Hospital, where he remains a patient. ANOC's presidential candidate Ralph Ramkaran is not pleased with the strides made by past governments, especially the coalition, who failed to deliver most of their promises.
In the lead-up to the 2015 elections, the APNU-AFC coalition campaigned on youth employment, the preservation of the sugar sector, and a good life for all Guyanese in a green economy. Now, as the election campaign heats up for the 2020 elections, presidential candidate for a new and a united Guyana, ANOG, Ralph Ramkaran, is picking a bone with the coalition. In his latest writing, Ramkaran affirmed that the APNU-AFC government has demonstrated no effort to implement its own proposals for a political solution, shared governance, or when it does not take all politics. He also stated that the party has failed to live up to its 2015 manifesto promise of constitutional reform. Contrary to the campaign messages of the coalition, in government, the sugar sector has been heavily condensed, while the government had said it is not their job to create employment for youths. But Ramkaran did not stop at the coalition. He also chided the People's Progressive Party for not developing Guyana enough, being in government since 1992 to 2015. Blowing his own trumpet, Ramkaran said his party intends to implement a political solution based on an executive equally balanced between the main political parties, a constituency-based electoral system with a mechanism to ensure proportionality, and a representative legislature which excludes the executive. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
An autopsy performed on 4-year-old Alex Prince, who was found dead last Monday, proved that the child died as a result of blunt trauma to the head. It also revealed that he was sodomized. The postmortem was done by government pathologist Dr. Nihal Singh at the Georgetown Public Hospital on Friday. As a result of the findings, the mother and stepfather of the child were immediately arrested and are currently being questioned. The lad was pronounced dead after he was found unconscious, naked, and with injuries to the head and eyes on Monday last about 12 hours by his stepfather at their home in Silver Hill on the Linden-Suisdijk Highway. It was reported that the child was discovered by his stepfather, who claimed that he left the child at home to go to a nearby shop to buy groceries to cook. The man said that when he returned from the shop, he found the unconscious child. An alarm was then raised and nurses from the nearby health center were summoned to the home. The child, however, succumbed on his way to the Linden Hospital complex. An investigation was immediately launched into the matter. Here is Celine Griffith with MTV's Court Roundup.
A laborer and father of two who allegedly gave his friend the gun which was used to shoot a man was today hauled before Magistrate Cherdell Isaacs Marcus at the Georgetown Magistrates Court. 26-year-old Adrian Scott of Seafield Sophia, Georgetown, was not required to plead to the indictable charge which alleged that on October 7 at Leopold Street Work in West Georgetown, with intent to maim, disfigure, disable, or cause grievous bodily harm, he unlawfully wounded Arlington Harper. According to reports, on the day in question, the victim went to a party at Leopold Street where he saw Scott. Reports indicate that shortly after, Scott left and returned with one Kurt Carter, who is wanted by the police in relation to the matter. Sometime later, the victim and Carter became involved in a fight, during which Scott allegedly pulled out a firearm from his waist and handed it to Carter. Carter then discharged a round in Harper's direction, which hit him to his lower back. The injured man fell to the ground and was rushed to the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation, where he remains a patient. Kurt Carter is currently being sought by the police. The man's lawyer, attorney at law, Kioma Griffith, told the court that his client is not the person who shot the man and requested that he be released on bail while stating that he is the sole breadwinner for his family. However, police prosecutor Shalon Daniel strongly objected to bail, citing the seriousness of the offense as well as the penalty it attracts, and highlighted the fact that the victim is still hospitalized. As such, Adrian Scott was denied bail and will make his next court appearance on November 18. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
Here is Ritesh Lakhan with this week's Star Computers Tech Wrap.
And welcome to the Star Technology Wrap. I'm your host, Rajesh Lakhan, and with me is Chanel, the Lenovo product rep at Star Computers. And this week we'll be touching on this tiny CPU by Lenovo. Tell us about it.
Yes, Rajesh. We have the Lenovo ThinkCentre Tiny. It's small, however, don't underestimate it. It has a high level of performance. It suits any industry. It could be a call center, it could be a restaurant, it could be any industry. It can be deployed in that.
Chanel, let's compare with the regular CPU and the Lenovo Tiny. What are the advantages?
All right, it's energy efficient, so on your light bill, it'll be very low consumption in energy. Also, it takes up less space, so you have more desk space to work with. Also, you can mount it at the back of a monitor.
In terms of a warranty and after sales service, tell us about that.
All right, well, this is a Lenovo product, and of course, you know, we are the authorized Lenovo dealer in Guyana, so you're guaranteed warranty and support from us.
Great, great. And as you know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and I'm repping my pink in support of that. And I also know that Star Computer has something special going on right now. Tell us about it.
Yes. Well, with the purchase of every HP 3785 all-in-one printer, 10% of the funds go to the Guyana Cancer Foundation. And this is to help bring awareness, because what is important is early detection helps to save lives. So get tested and ensure that you know what's happening with your body.
Tell us, what has been your response thus far?
All right, it's been excellent. Persons are definitely giving back to the cause.
Great, great. Aside from that, what else happened here?
All right, well, we have promotions ongoing, so feel free to like us on Facebook. Also, you can keep following us. You can also check our website.
Well, thank you, Chanel.
Thank you, Rajesh.
And that's what we have for you this week's edition of Star Technology Wrap. Do join us next week, Monday, for another edition.
Coming up after the break, MTV's sport update and more. Stay with us.
The Guyana Elections Commission would be conducting a claims and objections exercise from the 1st of October 2019. Persons have until the 4th of November 2019 to make a claim to be on the list if you will be 18 years or older by the 31st of December 2019, a Guyanese citizen by birth, descent, naturalization or registration, a citizen of a Commonwealth country living in Guyana for a period of no less than 1 year preceding the 31st of December 2019, persons who require changes or corrections to their particulars as stated on the preliminary list of electors, such as names, occupations, and transfers in relation to their addresses, can also do same during the claims and objections period. You must present the relevant original documents in order for the transaction to be completed. Don't delay. Visit the nearest GCAM registration office today. For more information, visit our website at www.gcam.org.gy. Follow GCAM on Facebook at Guyana Elections Commission. Contact us on 225-0277-9 or 223-9653. Email pro@gcam.org.gy. or the nearest GCAM registration office.
Turn your houses into homes at zemafurniture.gy, 249 Orinoco and Foreshore Streets, Georgetown. Telephone number 227-6609. Check us out for a wide variety of furniture for every part of your home. Get uniquely designed and high-quality bedroom sets, living room sets, dining room sets, entertainment sets, outdoor and kids' furniture, all at unbeatable prices. There is also a wide variety of lamps, mirrors, and other items to accessorize your home. All furniture imported from USA. Purchase a bedroom set and receive a lamp free. Zenofurniture.gy, adding a touch of comfort to your life.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Over the years, ISG has been providing all sectors across Guyana with quality products and outstanding customer service. Proud distributor of NP and Ultra lubricants, engineered for tropical conditions. International Trucks and Parts, leading the change. SEM Machinery, a Caterpillar brand. SKF Bearings and Mounted Products. Napa Batteries. Tide Power Generators. Discover the greatest source of power. Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
Controversially sacked after winning the 2016 T20 World Cup with the West Indies, Phil Simmons will make his return as head coach of the men's team.
Confirmed by the Cricket West Indies Board of Directors earlier today and will take a four-year spell. The former West Indies opening batsman previously served as the coach of the Afghanistan national team, helping them qualify for the World Cup in 2019 and on Sunday won the 2019 CPL coaching the Barbados Tridents. CWI President Ricky Skerritt said bringing Simmons back is not just righting a past wrong, but he is confident that he is the right man chosen. He extended thanks to Floyd Reefer for the hard work he put in as interim head coach. Reefer was one of three men shortlisted 2 weeks ago for the role alongside Simmons and Desmond Haynes. West Indies had been without a full-time coach since the CWI management led by Skerritt ended Richard Pybus's stint in April this year, just weeks before the World Cup, following a review of the team's coaching and selection policies. Reefer had been at the helm since. Chelsea Lee, reporting from TV's Sports Update.
On the heels of the 2019 Caribbean Premier League, two groups of five teams will run concurrently in St. Kitts and Nevis and Trinidad and Tobago as the Colonial Medical Insurance Super 50 Cup gets underway on November 6.
Zone A matches begin on the opening day and will take place every day in St. Kitts and Nevis, with the Zone B matches starting on November 7 at the Queen's Park Oval and the Brian Lara Cricket Academy in Trinidad. Each team will play their zonal opponents twice before the top two in each group progress to the semi-finals and a chance to play in the final in Trinidad on December 1. Reigning champions Combined Campuses and College Marooners will kickstart the tournament in Group A when they face hosts Leeward Islands Hurricanes, with Jamaica Scorpions, Barbados Pride and Canada being the other teams in Group A. Group B commences when Guyana Jaguars clash with the Trinidad and Tobago Red Force during a game at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. The aim of the West Indies Emerging Players Squad was to select the players for the Super 50 Cup and to facilitate further learning and development opportunities for players featured in the CWI High Performance Pathway. A special announcement will take place on Friday, October 18, to launch ticket sales and announce box office opening dates. Chelsea Lee, reporting from TV's Sports Update.
Hero Caribbean Premier League has announced the team of their 2019 tournament selected by Hero CPL's director Tom Moody and members of the commentary team.
The team will be captained by Shoaib Malik, who successfully led the Guyana Amazon Warriors to a record 11 victories. He will be joined by fellow Warriors Brandon King and Imran Tahir, who both played integral roles in the franchise's record success. The sole representative from the Jamaica Talos is Glenn Phillips, who will also be the wicketkeeper for the team. The Trinbago Knight Riders have two players in the team, Lendell Simmons and Kieron Pollard. The Barbados Tridents have three players who make the team, with Jason Holder and Harry Gurney both getting nods. The St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots have representation from Fabian Allen and Sheldon Cottrell. The head coach of the year is Johan Botha, who has taken Guyana Amazon Warriors into the CPL final with 11 straight wins. The 12th and 13th men are also from the Amazon Warriors, with Chris Green and Chandrapal Hemraj making up the rest of the squad. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sports Update.
Despite the title ending up in the hands of the Barbados Tridents after their perfect season unraveled at the CPL Finals, the Warriors' record-winning streak of 11 consecutive matches in CPL history will be remembered.
Guyana's streak is the fourth longest winning in major T20 leagues behind the Kolkata Knight Riders' 14 in the 2014 Indian Premier League. The Amazon Warriors have now finished runners-up in the CPL five times. No other team in any major T20 league have lost as many finals as Guyana. Heavy emphasis was placed on the Warriors' spin bowling, centralling their reigning success. Their spin attack was led by the duo of Chris Green and Imran Tahir and supported by Chandrapal Hemraj, Shoaib Malik and for three matches each, Shadab Khan and Kais Ahmad. This was a breakout tournament for 24-year-old Jamaican Brandon King, who finished as the tournament's leading run scorer with 496 runs for the Amazon Warriors, including a stunning century in Qualifier 1, the highest CPL score ever. Ahead of the season, Guyana's powerful middle order of Sherman Hetmyer, Nicholas Puran, Shoaib Malik and Sherfane Rutherford was identified as a key strength of the side. Brandon King's superb season transformed Guyana from a good team into an arguably great one. The Hero Caribbean Premier League and the Cricket West Indies have agreed a tournament window for the 2020 tournament. Next year's tournament will take place between August 19 and September 26, 2020. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sports Update.
Guyana's senior men's football team, the Golden Jaguars, will be seeking a vital win tonight at the Leonora Track and Field Center against Antigua and Barbuda in League B of the CONCACAF Nations League.
The Jaguars lost 1-2 to the hosts, Antigua, on Saturday, sending them to third on the points table, still with 3 points. Head coach Marcio Maximo indicated with Jamaica's Reggae Boys in the top spot, their focus should be on finishing second. Meanwhile, captain Sam Cox disclosed that their loss was disappointing, but he thinks they dominated possession and had it not been for the first lethargic 15 minutes of play, their results could have been different. Guyana will host Aruba November 15 before traveling to Jamaica 3 days later. Winner of the group will advance to the League A section of the competition in the subsequent edition. Jamaica has a perfect 9 points from 3 matches, followed by Antigua with 6 and Guyana on 3. Aruba are yet to gather a point. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sports Update.
The Ansa McCall's sponsored Lucozade Handicap Tournament closed off yesterday with Nicholas Narain crowned champion following 3 intense but successful matchups.
Daniel Ince took the plate title, while Luis da Silva copped his first title in the Category A group and Lejean Monroe nabbed the A plate. Nicholas Verwey was a truly worthy opponent in the ultimate matchup for the title. However, Narain tactically kept Verwey off the tee and worked him around the whole court in the first game. In the second, Verwey used his drops effectively and worked Narain into the corners to secure his win. The third game of an outstanding match of great depth, great squash and great athletes landed on the side of the experienced Narain for the 15-14, 13-15 and 15-11 win. In the open plate, Daniel Ince clashed with Ian McDacey, who slowed down what had been a fast-paced clash. Relying on talent in the decider rather than fitness, Ince was able to move up his deficit and close off the game at 15-9, 14-15 and 15-11. The title of the Category A was earned by a much-improved Luis da Silva over Zachary Persaud. Eventually, De Silva came out strong, pushing the last 2 points to close off in straight games 15-6 and 15-14. For the Category A plate, Joshua Verwey made a valiant effort with good lengths against eventual winner Lejeune Monroe. Monroe managed a 13-15 win in the first and Verwey answered with a 15-14 win in the second, but could not quite hold on in the third and conceded the decider. Monroe triumphed 15-13, 14-15 and 15-12. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV's Sports Update.
Roger Federer has confirmed he intends to play in next summer's Olympics in Tokyo as he chases an elusive gold medal in the men's singles. The Swiss great, who turns 39 during the games, is one of the sport's most decorated players, but he has never won the Olympic singles title. Federer won silver at London 2012 after losing to Britain's Andy Murray. Federer, who missed Rio 2016 through injury, did win a gold medal at Beijing 2008 in the men's doubles alongside Stan Wawrinka. In the singles, 20-time Grand Slam champion Federer finished fourth at Sydney 2000, lost in the second round at Athens 2004, and reached the quarterfinals in Beijing. More news after the break. Stay with us.
Over the years, ISG has been providing all sectors across Guyana with quality products and outstanding customer service. Proud distributor of NP and Ultra lubricants, engineered for tropical conditions. International Trucks and Parts, leading the change. SEM Machinery, a Caterpillar brand. SKF Bearings and Mounted Products, Napa Batteries. Tide Power Generators, discover the greatest source of power. Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc., the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome back. You're still with MTV's News Update. In the region, Ecuador's government has agreed to restore fuel subsidies in a deal with indigenous leaders to end mass protests that have brought the capital Quito to a standstill, the UN says. It came after the two sides held talks brokered by the UN and the Roman Catholic Church. The talks, which were broadcast live on state television, came after nearly 2 weeks of violent demonstrations. President Lenin Moreno had imposed a curfew enforced by the military. A joint statement said the government had withdrawn an order removing the fuel subsidies. An international scene. Syria's army has started to reach the north of the country hours after the government agreed to help Kurdish forces facing Turkey. This is seen as a boost for President Bashar al-Assad, as it is the first time his troops, which are backed by Russia, will enter those areas since 2012. The deal came after the U.S., the Kurds' main ally, said it would withdraw its remaining troops from northern Syria. Turkey's offensive aims to push Kurdish forces from the border. Syrian state media said forces had entered a strategic tongue of Manbij inside the area where Turkey wants to create a safe zone cleared of Kurdish fighters. Earlier, the army pushed into Tal Tamer and Ain Issa, where residents celebrated their arrival. The swift deployment followed U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper's announcement on Sunday that up to 1,000 U.S. troops would be removed from northern Syria, citing fears that they would end up stuck between two opposing advancing armies. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Guyana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 847. Let's turn our attention to the Denver Harbor Bridge and Burbage River Bridge schedules. This is where we will wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Businessman shot dead outside Kitty Gold dealership as Ghana records 12 murders in 7 days. Pro-democracy activist allegedly assaulted, arrested for protesting unconstitutional president. Partly decomposed body of another piracy victim found. Mother-stepfather arrested as autopsy found 4-year-old boy was sodomized. And in sport, Phil Simmons returns as West Indies head coach as Guyanese Harper and Dowling handed selector roles. Catch our rebroadcast at 23 hours today and 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Ashley Scotland. Good night.